When you animate in Final Cut Pro, whether using keyframes or the Ken Burns effect, there are advanced controls that you may not have noticed. In this tutorial, you'll see how to use these controls for your Final Cut animations. I call these controls the Ease In and the Ease Out controls, such as the animation slowly and smoothly starting and ending without snapping. At the end of the tutorial, I'll show you further tips on how to use these controls. I'm Bruce Macbryde, and I can provide training in Final Cut over the internet. Just click on this link, training.finalcutpro.com. And if you've got any topics you'd like covered, let me know in the comments below. Let's get right into it. First, I'll show you the Ease In and the Ease Out controls for the Ken Burns effect, and then I'll show you the fine controls for keyframe animation. And then finally, Ease In and Ease Out for keyframed opacity changes. Let's look at the Ease In and Ease Out control for Ken Burns. Make sure the clip is selected in the timeline. Right-click on the beginning or the end point. You've got several choices. Ease In and Out, Just Ease In, and Just Ease Out, as well as Linear. If I show you Linear first, you'll get a better feel for the others. The image snaps into view, plays through smoothly, and then snaps out of view. The Ease Out control softens the beginning so that it does not snap in as distinctly. It actually starts slowly from the beginning and then moves quickly towards the end. Equally, the Ease In does the same at the end of the clip. It starts quickly from the beginning and then moves slowly towards the end. And finally, the Ease In and Ease Out affects both the softness at both ends. Now let's look at the fine controls for keyframing. Select the clip you want to animate in the timeline. I'll use this clip to increase the view of the right-hand yacht. This is the clip playing without any keyframes. And I'll quickly add the keyframes to make the right-hand yacht more prominent. Select the beginning of the clip in the timeline. Right-click in the viewer and select Transform. In the keyframe control window at the top left of the viewer, click the diamond with the plus sign in the middle. Now move the playhead in the timeline to the point where the right-hand yacht comes into view. With the Option key down, select the left bottom blue dot and drag out to show a bigger view of that yacht. A keyframe is added automatically each time you reposition the clip in the viewer. So now move the playhead in the timeline to almost the end of the clip and reposition again. A new keyframe is automatically added again. And if I move back to view the path, I can see that the yacht almost goes off the screen. And I can add another keyframe here by moving the image in the viewer up to a more pleasing position. Another keyframe is automatically added. Now if I scrub through, you can see that the yacht stays more in view. Each of these keyframes can be clicked and the fine controls then become available. By left-clicking, you have Bezier curves that allow a fine change of the path. A right click on the keyframe shows other controls. You can select either linear or smooth, and smooth's the default. You'll mostly use smooth unless a keyframe is close to the edge of the screen. That's when the smooth control may cause the clip to go beyond the edge. If that happens, use the linear. And the other choices, you've got delete point, lock point, and disable. You'd use lock point to fix a point so that when you are positioned on a keyframe in the image in the viewer, it's fixed and can't be moved. I've locked the keyframe, and now when I try to drag the image, it won't move. Let's unlock that. The final choice is disable, and this temporarily removes the keyframe, allowing you to re-enable it again if you need. Now let's look where we've added keyframes to change the opacity on a timeline clip. Let's change the opacity on the yacht clip to fade it out. Select Show Video Animation from the clip menu, and that's Control plus V. Position the playhead, press Option plus K. A keyframe is added. Now move the playhead and press Option plus K, or click exactly on the line with the Option key down. Another keyframe is added. drag that second dot down to reduce the opacity at that point. And these controls work the same way as the ease in and ease out controls of the Ken Burns effect. Hold the Command key and drag on the descending line. It changes to an ease line. Right-click on that line and these are the choices. Linear, which is a straight line and is the default setting. Ease. This fine control gives a smoother start to the opacity change and it also smooths the end. Ease in. Starts quickly and is smoother at the end. Ease out. This is smoother in the beginning and snappy in the end. Right-click on the first dot and both keyframes can be deleted. Right-click on any other keyframe dot and just that point can be deleted. And that's everything you need to know about the fine controls for animation in Final Cut Pro. Let me know in the comments below if you've got areas that you struggle with in Final Cut. I'd be happy to do a tutorial to help you with those issues. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell. There are new videos every Sunday.